Come back to the game. So, if you're afraid of heights, don't look at this. Yeah, it's big, it's empty, and it's scary. We are kind of in a very, very bad position. So this is the top of the mountain where the walker crashed. And we should find some loot around here. It says various loot, but we'll also find some enemies. Easy, easy, don't let my hand slip. But the game is back online and it should stay online for a very long time, and it's also not going to wipe the progress of the stress test. But I still have problems getting a lot of FPS. And yeah, the game still has performance problems which are not really explained by anyone. Yeah, that's the game, it's an unoptimized game. Huge, huge walkers over here. Oh, that's so nice with the wings in the wind and yeah. Feels almost like a lost oasis and you can hear the wind. So later on in the game you'll actually be able to build giant walkers like this one. But for now let's check it out a little closer. Looks like a disaster site. Well, clipping, yeah. At least they don't kill me. So they actually used the designs of some writer or someone who designed this, I don't know. Package, nice. So that's why the design of the walker is so unique and so interesting. They mentioned whose designs they used, but I forgot. Really, really great. Now, what did we get? We get some wood and some ashes, but of course, we got the fragments, which are the most important. Yeah, let's explore this a little more. We could try to go lower than this, but it seems like a bad idea. Okay, let's not go down, let's go up. It's almost like we're visiting an abandoned amusement park, even though this is clearly something very, very strange. Okay, can we get up there? Because, as I said, later in the game you'll be able to build these giant walkers and you'll also be able to grapple on the enemy walkers. But still, it's a PvP game. Also, this game has a unique system where if you go to the world map, you can move to another oasis, but it's just like a normal server. So this is 110 EU. That will be 109. And Cradle means it's a starting oasis, but you also have the option to go to the Lost Plateau, which is an advanced oasis, sort of speaking. Also, as you can see, it says not claimed yet. What? Hey man, I was doing a video, that's so mean. Oh. Yeah, full on PvP, and my bed is actually very far away from this place. Was this person hitting me with their fist? Well, that Rupu looks very angry. I lost the girl or the boy, whatever he was. He's certainly not a he. That person was certainly not a lady, because a lady would not attack me while I'm explaining stuff. Anyway, if you move to another oasis, you can actually switch servers. So servers in this game are very well made in the sense that you can't really lose your progress. You just move to another server. Also, healing is very, very slow. And now what? Hey, come on. Oh, there are two of them. Okay, then we run away. Kind of silly that they want to PvP in an area like this. And that person also has unlocked the staff, which is just a better weapon. Anyway, I recently died, so I didn't get anything new. Okay, waste your time with me then. Ouch, that broke my feet. Okay, this is kind of like what I wanted to show. Nah, doesn't really matter. The point of the game is, of course, it's a full PvP. And it's kind of sad that people, you know, overlevel themselves and stay in the same area, and then they start killing the people who are not overlevel like they are. Let's see, I think I lost some weird materials along the way, but nothing special. But yeah, the main problem is that they will keep me as it says there. Some of my gear will stay intact until I hit level 20. What level am I? 17. A few more levels. But I also need to get up there and loot the place. Well, that's just my luck. Let's go again. like I said, I'm not losing anything. And those guys, I think they had the max tier weapons for this area. I hope they don't ruin my walker. That would be really mean. Plus, that's like a one-hit weapon for my current loadout. Lot of monkey business over here. I love the sound of bare feet on the rocks. Okay, let's also bandage up to full health and then we'll see what we can do. I mean, I can just keep this forever up. Yeah, now I think she's running away because she doesn't want to fight me alone. Yeah, whatever. The goal was to explore the place, but I guess you saw the PvP mechanics and kind of like how the game is. You can respawn at your bed or at your walker. So, let me see what. Not in the mood for fighting, to be honest. Oh, weird trash pile over here. I guess we can steal that fiber. Yeah, let's take out the recipes. We can do some damage over there as well, but I just wanted to explore and find the fragments of this place. Now, from what I know, there should be a chest or something over here that spawns at least. And yeah, people can kill you from the first minute of the game, and that's another crazy thing about the game. But sometimes it's just better to pretend you are a noob and you don't know what you're doing. Is this a catapult or was a catapult? Okay, that was a bit scary, to be honest. But yeah, you can climb up some really high structures. What am I hitting? The small... Oh, this is so scary. Just look at this place. Okay, you can chop it with your axe. And then you can click loot. So we got two fragments, which are the things that interest me. Fragments. I don't know. I guess this stays like this until you find all the loot you need. Oh, okay. So over there we have another pile of loot. Wish me luck. Ooh, hit my head over there. Yeah, so you'll actually drop the line when you are very, very tired. Also, I forgot to bring water with me. Let's see, we should be able to actually go up if we do it like this. Okay, climbing activated. So that's another fragment. As you can see, I lose the things over here, but I don't really need them. Okay, so up there and up here, that was the chest location and the loot location. I guess it's the same for the other ones as well. You can also climb down using your hook, but I think I accidentally hit something else. Okay, so I understand why people are farming this place, because it's a good place to get a lot of those fragments. Let's see, let's Indiana Jones this. Okay, it worked decently well. Now, I think there might be another looting node over here. A little on the buggy side, but yeah. As I expected. Ta-da! Actually, this was nothing good. Hide. Actually, I need a lot of hide. Let's keep the hides. Stones I think I already have, and they are kind of easy to get. Wow, this is such a huge place anyway. And looks like there are some platforms over there as well. Okay, let's do a little more exploring before I actually die of thirst. Again, sorry about the lag and the performance loss, but yeah. That's so cool. That's one of the reasons I'm still playing the game even though it had so many problems. It's because of the concept, it's so, I don't know, so new and so well designed. Okay, let's try to go over there. Ouch, what a bad idea. Let's not go over there because it's not possible. Actually, when I end the video, I'll just have to come back and see if I can find more loot. A barrel? Well, I didn't think about this. Oh, nice. Some more hides and some more fragments. That was a cool location. Well, I guess I can save some of those bandages by just crafting... I mean that fiber by crafting bandages. And I didn't see any cactuses on this place, so yeah, I don't think there is any water over here. Also, let's go to this side. Oh, can I go over there as well? Ah, as soon as I saw this, I think, hey, there's a chest in there. I have to research. I have to go and get it. Nothing really interesting, but the fiber weave is definitely useful. Oh, okay. I guess that's the sound it makes when you're about to die out first. Actually, let's go to this place and die, because that was a lot of exploring we just did. My character really sounds thirsty, and my stamina is dropping. Oh well, it seems like I won't reach this place. Wow, that's a really death sound. By the way, when you die, you lose all the water in your little baggies, in your little cups. Okay, so there was nothing interesting here, maybe up this ramp. I think it spawns at random intervals, so yeah, your best bet is to play on a very low population server and then move to a high population server. Who wants to attack me when I'm dying? That's just mean. Yeah, I think they should put a few cactuses up here, because it's kind of hard to get the water. Especially if people camp the place like those guys did. Oh well, this is still a lot of fun. Hey, get away from me, ape. Oh, now my health is dropping. Okay, maybe the ape will kill me. Too slow, ape. It's such a colorful place over here, but so dangerous. Is that a big statue in the distance? Nice, by the way, you don't find bones in the cradle area. It's going to be in one of the other areas. So sooner or later, you just have to move out of your starting area. Oh, it's a sad. I feel so sneaky and dirty right now. But yeah, don't be mean to your other players, because they'll be mean back at you. Also, there is a chat in the game, but I don't know the key binding. I mean, a proximity chat, that is. Push to talk is okay. Okay, let's respawn at my sand vent. And then let's run again to the walker, but first of all I want to see if I can find some cactuses. Well, there is a lot of rope over here. Yeah, those silly apes. As you can see, I lost some inventory stuff, but nothing too interesting. So, is that another ruin in the distance I see? Whatever. Yeah, there are really no cactuses around this place, so you have to come prepared with a lot of water. Or, you know, kill someone else and steal their water, because that's the way of the desert. Yeah, they look very weird. Again, sorry about the performance troubles. I don't know how to fix them because... Okay, that's a barrel over there. Even if I take my settings, my graphic options to the lowest possible, it still is the same frames. Oh, is that a crow's nest or whatever? Okay, let's check the crow's nest and then I'll end the video. That's quite a lot of things we found out today. Oh, it might be a loot in that crow's nest because this one is actually very tipped. Yeah, let's waste some time and go and get them. Remember, if you have your sand bed in a very remote place, no one can destroy it. People are over here. And that's a net, so they can actually throw a net on your walker and that's how they stop you. So I might find some dead people over here. Wow, there is really no water, so water is the most important resource in the game after all. Come on, leave me alone. I am a man with a mission. Well, there is nothing up here, but it's a good spot to hide from the apes. Well, see you next time. Bye.